and gentlemen, in preparation for our final heat, Killcliff coming around, Taste the Tasty. They're gonna come around and throw out some free gear, make some noise. You want some shades? Killcliff, our title sponsor this weekend, the top recovery drink on the market. Don't just put your hands up, we need to hear you, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Irwin, president of Killcliff, throwing them out personally. There we go, keep making noise. You want it, they'll come over to you. You're making noise, they'll follow you. And it can be to enjoy the applause for Killcliff as well as for your top six teams now taking the floor. To introduce your top six teams here at the 2014 ECC, down in lane number six, consisting of Games veteran Jared Davis, Spencer Hendel, Stacy Croon, and Erica Snyder. We've got the Twerks and Jerks. In lane number five, we've got Games veterans galore as well, consisting of Michelle Latondra, Simone Paquette, Emily Pfeiffer-Badeau, and Jean-Michel Rendeau. That is Team Wrecking Ball. In lane number four, sitting in fourth place, the team consisting of Christy Atkins, Maddie Curley, James Hobart, and Austin Maliolo, Pasty and Irish. And now for your top three teams, just to give you guys an update on the standings. Only 8 points separating first from third. This last workout, as was the case yesterday, worth double the points, 200 points. So if any of these three teams can win, they will be standing atop the podium. In lane number three, in third place, consisting of Adrian Conway, Brooke Entz, Tommy Hackenbrook, and Mandy Janowitz, Hex Pack. Leading by a point over Hex Pack, we have our team here in lane number two. Athletes consisting of Elizabeth Akinwale, the Rich Crony, the Chris Spieler, and the Stacy Tovar. We have your dream team! And hanging on to first place by 7 points coming into this final workout, we've got the athletes Talena Fortunato, Emily Friedman, Noah Olson, and Guido Trinidad, representing your team, Dirty South. 10 seconds. Athletes set.
All right, there you have it. All right, welcome to the 2014 East Coast Championships. My name is Miles Lewis alongside Tanya Wagner. We are set for the final event of the team workout. What is in store for these guys?
The girls are already underway. This is the first event where we are seeing the women take the lead and go first. Both women have to go through this next part of the workout with 20 shoulder to overhead with 165 pounds on the bar. Then they're going to be following
that. 165 pounds.
Yeah, no
joke.
Yeah,
that is crazy.
165 on the bar. This is the heaviest we've seen. so far this competition, heavier than the individuals went yesterday. But you have to remember, these are the apex of the teams here today. This is the final event. They are here ready to do work. After the 20 shoulder to overhead, which they are allowed to break however they want, they're going to move on to a buddy shuttle where each athlete will carry the other one a set distance back and forth. They're going to move on to handstand walks, and then they're going to finish with a front rack partner walking lunge, which is going to wreak havoc on some of these ladies that are different heights. And then they're going to come back through the ladder, going back to the handstand walks, the buddy shuttle, and they will finish with another set of 20 165 pounds shoulder to overheads. Once the two women complete this, they'll move on to the men doing the same thing.
Right there is Stacy Tovar and Elizabeth Akinwale making that 165 look real light.
Super impressive that they can hang on to this weight. Stacy Tovar choosing to just do a regular push jerk while you see Emily Friedman here in the front of your screen using the split jerk.
All right, Stacy Tovar, there it is. And Talena Fortunato move on to the buddy carry.
Buddy shuttle, however you want, you can carry however you want. Choosing just to go in the back, no problem. They'll carry down all the way, 50 feet.
Right, remember, back. A lot at stake here. First, second, and third place currently in lanes 1, 2, and 3 are the three teams that can take over and win. If they win this event, that's it. They win the whole day.
So they will know side by side. They're going to know where they stand the entire time. And it's so important for these women to get off to a good start, set the guys up for as much time as they can.
Right now, a slight lead out of Team Dirty South right there. So handstand walks next.
Same thing, the women will have to wait till both athletes get to the mat. Pause, they're gonna come back. You can see Elizabeth Akinwale waiting for Stacy Tovar. They'll head back to the mat and then again finish with another buddy shuttle, and they're gonna come right back down the ladder now.
Right now, building up a bigger lead, Team Dirty South. Talena and Emily both moving quickly through the buddy carry.
A quick switch, great transition. And you can see Elizabeth Akinwale making it easier to hold on with her legs. Bending her legs, making it easier to hold on for Stacy to hold her legs.
All right, Talena and Emily both back on the bar.
Talena Fortunato also using the split jerk. It's faster so you can get underneath the bar, but it does take a little more time then to reset your feet. You must be overhead with your arms locked out and feet underneath your hips before you can bring that bar back down.
We see off to the right there, Elizabeth Akinwale getting moving that push jerk real fast. Emily moving quickly as well.
Very impressive. End of the weekend, end of the day for the girls, able to hold on and string these reps together.
Good going rep for rep with each other. Talena, Elizabeth both grabbing the bar, looking real strong and confident out there. So right now the action's between lanes 1 and 2.
And as soon as they complete these 20 shoulder to overhead, the men will slide their bar forward and they will get started with the exact same movements. Their barbell will be weighing 245 pounds.
Wow. All right, Dirty South in lane 1 off to your left, holding the lead right now, Stacy Tovar. Off to your right with the Dream Team. Elizabeth Akinwale grabbing the bar. This is actually a pretty confident move for her. There is a 25-minute time cap on this workout.
Elizabeth Akinwale just holding that bar, able to drop underneath.
With that fist up, the judge is signaling that there are 5 reps remaining in this heat. So just 3 more reps to go for the Dirty South team. Right, Dream Team off to 14 reps, so 15 reps to go, or 5 reps to go for the Dream Team, and 1 rep to go for Team Dirty South. Missing the clean, that's gonna hurt a little bit.
Huge. Emily having a hard time getting that barbell up to her shoulders.
And there, Talena finishes the last rep. Elizabeth Akinwale making quick work of those reps. So it's a close race. Now, the lunges are next.
They finish up, and I'm sorry, they do finish up with the front rack partner lunge. They're holding the bar together. It helps for them. They're both on the taller side. Talena's a little bit taller. The only requirement here is that their back knee must touch the ground, but Talena does not need to stand up to full extension.
All right, so there's Team Dirty South with a lead over the Dream Team. Right back behind them, we've got Elizabeth and Stacy grabbing and getting started on their lunges, so not too far behind them in lane number two. So right now, Team Dirty South holding on to that first place.
And this is definitely an awkward movement. You have to have teamwork there. It's so important that to work together there and not have that barbell fall forward.
All right, there starts the men, 20 shouldered overhead. Guido Trinidad making that weight look real light and easy.
Again,
that's 245 pounds.
Yow.
Yeah, that is a lot of weight. All right, Dream Team just getting finished with their lunges. Move on to the bar. Here comes Rich Froning. Might save a couple reps for Chris.
I foresee the same thing. We're going to hold on to that bar, see how many he can string together. Making that look light. They know this is what it comes down to. The men have to get through this workout. Whoever is first will be the winner of the entire day.
14 reps there for Team Dirty South. 5 reps to go. Rich Froning, 10 reps, wow, 10 reps straight at 245. Pretty big deal.
Sweet,
there.
Sweet sassy molassy, that boy is strong.
And there goes Chris Spieler, weighing in 155 pounds. He's also getting rep for rep.
Now you notice a little different buddy carry here, not on the back. I prefer more of the fireman's carry here. It's a little easier to run with, not as much bouncing.
And there's Froning finishing up those last reps.
Very strong. Here we go.
And there goes Froning and Spieler onto their buddy carry.
Now, if there were any other athlete, I would say, at the size of Chris Spieler, I would say, you know, he's going to be slower. But Chris Spieler, he will be fine with Rich. No big deal. He's got him right away. No problem.
All right. Awesome performance out of Chris. Grabbing Rich, throwing him over his shoulder like he's practiced it before. Dragging him down. Same thing. Now these guys are back on their second rounds of buddy carry. Different technique. Now we got to hold on. I can't drag any body parts there. All right. Still in the lead, Team Dirty South. Moving quickly through the buddy carries.
But look at Rich and Spiel. They are basically sprinting down on these handstand walks, and now they're going to get right back on the buddy carries.
Jumping right on Rich like a monkey. Rich grabbing Spieler and going with him.
Slight little mental error, though. Spiel went to go back to the bar, forgot they had to come back on the buddy carries.
All right, Team Dirty South back on the bar. 20 shouldered overhead.
20 to shoulder overhead, and then they're going to finish with
lunges.
That lunge.
Remember, a lot is at stake here.
Spiel is moving.
Moving quick. Spieler on a mission right now.
They've done this before. Rich knows how to balance himself on his back, make it be as easy as possible. Oh, and no, with a failed rep.
All right, here's where it's going to come down to the line right now. Rich and Spiel grab the bar, and this is where you're going to start to see some action happening. Guido jumping into those 20 shoulder overheads. Now the weight's starting to look heavy. You can see the grinching in his face. Yes. Off to the right-hand side at lane number two. Back on the bar, Rich and Chris. And it's a close battle right now.
Side by side.
First place is on the line. Any one of these teams take first place, and we're going to see champions.
Rich, they have a hold on to that bar. Spiel is jumping right in.
All right, Chris, calm, cool, and collected. 155 pound body weight, making that 245 look relatively easy.
And he's gonna cycle. String them together, Chris.
All right, 9 reps into it for the team on the left there, Team Dirty South, and right behind them. There's 7 reps for the Dream Team, 10 reps for the Team Dirty South. Real close race right now, it's gonna come down to the wire. All right, the transitions are key right now. Who can get those 20 reps done? Noah taking a couple extra reps that might have been enough.
You can't have any mental errors here. You have to make every rep count. You can't jump back on the bar too soon and have any failed lifts.
All right, 5 reps to go for Team Dirty South. Right behind them, Rich Froning Jr. trying to rack up those reps. And two more reps for Rich Froning Jr. 1 rep for Spiel. Let's see if it's going to come down to the wire. Right now, the Dream Team and Noah Olson on the front here in Team Dirty South. And wow, Dream Team takes on the lead right now with the lunges. Chris Spiel and Rich Froning took over, and they are doing work on those lunges right now. All is on the line. If they win this heat, they will win the event.
The legend, the champ, this is why that is their names. This is why we love to watch these men compete. Amazing performance.
And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. You are champions of this weekend right there. Rich Froning, Chris Spieler, Stacy Tavar, and Elizabeth Akinwale right behind them, Team Dirty South. Wow, what an awesome performance to end this weekend.
They stayed in their game. They knew what they had to do. They were able to capitalize at the end there, hold it out. Amazing performance.
All right. One more lunge to go for those guys. They got to get that whole foot over the line before they can lunge. Wow. That is it for Team Dirty South. They will take second place. Your Dream Team, Rich Froning, Chris Spieler, Elizabeth Akinwale, and Stacy Tovar have taken the lead and are now the winners of the East Coast Championship.
And for the Dirty South, that was an amazing performance. They look a little bummed, of course, for the just getting squeaked out by the Dream Team for first place, but that was an amazing performance all the way through. Noah Olson pushing as hard as he could there at the end. Guido Trinidad as well. They're just up against some amazing men. They're freaks of nature. Great performance all around by both teams.
You know, we had a chance to talk to Chris earlier, and he was just saying it's all about having fun with the boys this weekend. But I don't know about you, that did not look like fun. Chris went out there, and he was on a mission, and he sure proved it right there.
It's built in. It's in their DNA. They're competitors at heart. It's just what they do. It's what Chris does. He picked up Rich like it was no big deal. He threw him over his shoulder and ran with him. Chris is just made for competition. He knows how to do it. Same thing for Rich, for Stacy, Elizabeth. They're all strong competitors.
Wow, what a great way to end this. And right now the race is for third place. We've got behind them the Pasty and Irish team, and the Hackspack, you trying to battle it out for that third place podium finish. So it's going to be a close, tight race. We'll see how the scores pan out. We do have plenty of time. Ben Bergeron did put a 25-minute time cap on this workout, and it looks like these tough teams will not need that time at all. So there's Tommy in the background getting those shouldered overheads done. And there is Team Pasty and Irish, Austin Mialiola and James Hobart, both from CrossFit New England, Reebok CrossFit One. Great athletes trying to get those handstand walks done.
And Austin's arms can wrap around James Hobart and hold on. Yeah. His arms for days. He's going to use it to his advantage and hang on.
Yeah, it's almost like a cat jumping on your shoulders there, you know, fast. He just grips on. All right, there's the Hackspack team getting done with their lunges. And that's going to be the third place team right there.
In sync, very nice pace. Keeping step for step, elbows are even at the same height. Very strong finish.
And there's your third place athletes. The Hackspack Ute out of Ute CrossFit, Adrian Conway, Brooke Enns, Tommy Hackenbrook, and Manny Janowitz. All phenomenal athletes, perform great at both the single and the individual level and as a team. There we have the Wrecking Ball team out of Canada also finishing up. So this is gonna shake things up in the fourth and fifth seats, but we'll see how the judges' scorecards tally up.
They've been a strong team, strategizing, communicating all day long. We've seen great work from them. You can still see we're going to get it to the end. He's telling left, right, we're going down, up. Great communication here to the end, even though he's exhausted.
Yeah, great show put on by the wrecking ball team. Michelle Letendre, Simon Paquette, Emily and Bulgine. And then there you have the twerks and the jerks.
And
Jared and Spencer, both two big, strong athletes.
And you can see the pain on their faces. This bar is heavy. It's very awkward to a front rack lunge yourself, yet alone with someone else.
A little height difference there. Might throw things off a little bit, but finishing up with the lunges, what a strong weekend out of these guys.
Great push. The girls are cheering them on all the way through that finish line.
All right, there's the Pasty and the Irish finishing up their shoulder overheads. Austin Maliola, strong competitor there. That's 245 pounds over his head. Five reps remain for the Pasty and the Irish team.
Can James hold on to that bar for all five? Stumbled there a bit to lock out. He's using
That's
a split
reps,
jerk.
Yeah.
Looks good.
Two reps remain.
He wants to do it.
One rep to go. That's all he needs to finish this. And then the lunge. And there you have it. Now he's going to lunge. Him and Austin are going to grab that bar, front rack position, and they'll head off on the lunge.
Now, that just didn't wipe out too much from him. Hopefully he can get himself back together, take a breath, and then get that timing down right now for these final lunges.
A little awkward there. It's okay. They head off on the lunge,
James,
and they're
going to
take it all the way.
James is a little taller. Just creates a little awkward angle for Maliola.
Yeah, James and Austin, phenomenal athletes, great performers on and off the field, real nice guys to talk to.
Training partners, they went down the East Coast a couple years ago, stopped at our affiliate. Two great guys and strong competitors.
And that's it for them. Great performance out of these athletes.
Real good effort.
A great performance out of all these athletes. And wow, what a weekend. We saw the individuals yesterday, the teams today, and just a great group of folks throwing down and just doing awesome things this weekend.
A lot of fit athletes out there, some amazing performances, people that just came from behind, overcame a lot of things, a lot of strategy, a lot of teamwork today, good communication. And the best thing is the camaraderie that you see amongst and the respect everybody has as fellow competitors.
So we will be back in about 5 minutes for the award ceremony. You won't want to miss that one. There's a lot of money on the line. Let's see who gets it. We will see you back here in 5 minutes.